Oh my God, last night. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, last night. I get so excited. I was too enthusiastic. Thank you for not laughing. Well, you laughed a little bit at one point when I was touching you and said I might lose consciousness, which you said was adorable, and I just have to trust that you don't think I'm an idiot or some kind of an animal. I never lost control due to overwhelming lust, but I must say that I'm changing my major to Joan. Changing my major to sex with Joan. Changing my major to sex with Joan, with a minor in kissing Joan. Foreign study to Jones and her thighs. A seminar on Jones' ass in her Levi's. And Joan's crazy brown eyes. Joan, I feel like Hercules. Oh God, that sounds ridiculous. Just keep on sleeping through this, son. I'll work on calming down, so by the time you've woken up, I'll be cool, I'll be collected, and I'll have found some dignity. But who needs dignity? 'Cause this is so much better. I'm radiating happiness. Will you stay here with me for the rest of the semester? We won't need any food. We'll live on sex alone. Sex with Joan. I don't know who I am. I'll become someone new. Nothing I just did is anything I would do. I'm scared. Am I falling into nothingness? Or flying into something so sublime? I don't know, but I'm changing my major to Joan. I thought all my life I'd be all alone, but that was before I was lying prone in this dorm room bed with Joan. Look, she drooled on the pillow. So sweet, all sweaty and tangled up in my bedsheet. And my heart feels complete. Let's never leave this room. How about we stay here till finals? I'll go to school forever. I'll take out a dementedly huge high interest loan. 'Cause I'm changing my major to Joan. My mind is clearer now. At last, all too well, I can see where we all soon will be. If you strip away the myth from the man, you will see where we all soon will be. Jesus, you've started to believe the things they say of you. You really do believe this talk of God is true. You've done will soon get swept away. You've begun to matter more than the things you say. Listen, Jesus, I don't like what I see. All I ask is that you listen to me. And remember, I've been your right-hand man all along. You have set them on fire. They think they found the new Messiah. And they'll hurt you when they find they're wrong. Listen, Jesus, do you care for your race? Don't you see we must keep in our place? We are occupied. Have you forgotten how bedad we are?
They'll crush us if we go too far. Listen, Jesus, to the warning I give. Don't you see that I want us to live? But it's sad to see our chances weakening with every hour. All your followers are blind. Too much heaven on their minds. It was beautiful, but now it's sour. Yes, it's all gone sour. It's
Lord, why are you thus alone? For what offense have I this fortnight been a banished woman from my Harry's bed? Tell me, sweet Lord, what is it that takes from thee thy stomach pleasure and thy golden sleep? Why dost thou bend thine eyes upon the earth and start so often when thou sittest alone? Why hast thou lost the fresh blood in thy cheeks, and given my treasures and my rights of thee to thick-eyed musing and cursed melancholy? In thy faint slumbers I by thee have watched, and heard thee murmur tales of iron wars, speak terms of manage to thy bounding steed, cry, courage, to the field! And thou hast talked of sallies and retires, of trenches, tents, of palisados, frontiers, parapets, of basilisks, of cannon, culverin, of prisoners ransom, and of soldiers slain, and all the currents of a heady fight. Thy spirit within thee hath been so at war, and thus hath so bestirred thee in thy sleep that beads of sweat have stood upon thy brow like a late disturbed stream. And in thy face strange motions have appeared, such as we see when men restrain their breath on some great sudden hest. Oh, what portents are these? Some heavy business hath my lord in hand, and I must know it, else he loves me not.
Sure, I'll talk to him. I'll say, what do you want here, you big swollen-headed stiff? Get! Then he'll say, I just come out to meet you, honey. Then I'll say, I don't want to get met by you. Get away from me. Take your hands off me. I hate you. Then he'll say, now, honey. Then I'll say, don't honey me. You thought I double-crossed you. Thought I was trying to show you up. Then I'll continue. When you did find out that I only done the trick to make you love me, why didn't you love me? Why did you leave? Why didn't you write? Then he'll say, 'cause I was shamed. Sides, not writing don't mean somebody don't love somebody. Then I'll say, just the same, you could write. Then he'll say, honey, I've been eating my heart out for you. Can't work, can't sleep. Of course, even he says that, I'm gonna have to say, I ain't slept much too. Then by rights he ought to say, Annie, we both just gotta get some sleep. And I love you so. And then I guess I won't be able to stop myself from saying, I love you too. Then there won't be nothing left for him to say but Annie.